One of the most important equations in fluids is the continuity equation or conservation of mass. And here we're going to look at it in its differential form. So this is d rho dt plus d rho u dx plus d rho v dy plus d rho w dz, and in order for conservation of mass to be satisfied, that has to be equal to zero. And rho equals our density. We can also write it in this form, where d rho dt plus del dot rho v equals zero. Let's suppose we have a steady flow. Then this reduces to del dot rho v equals zero, since there is no time dependence. Now, let's assume we have incompressible flow. Since we have incompressible flow, density does not change, and so we can pull it out of the equation. And since the equation equals zero, we can get rid of density and we are left with del dot v equals zero. Or written in our differential form, du dx plus dv dy plus dw dz equals zero. This not only satisfies the continuity or conservation of mass equation, it also means that the volume dilatation rate is equal to zero. We can also look at it in cylindrical coordinates and simplify it as necessary. So we start again with d rho dt plus 1 over r dr rho v sub r dr plus 1 over r d rho v theta d theta plus d rho vz dz, and this has to equal zero. So again, we can look at it as steady, which means our d rho dt term equals zero. And finally, we can look at it in incompressible flow, and we end up with 1 over r d r v r dr plus 1 over r d v theta d theta plus d v z d z, and that equals 0. So if we have a steady, incompressible, plane, two-dimensional flow, our continuity equation simplifies, so plane, two-dimensional, steady state, incompressible, to du dx plus dv dy equals zero. And what this does is it allows us to define what's known as a stream function. So this is defined in terms of u and v, such that u equals the derivative of the stream function with respect to y, and v equals negative the derivative of the stream function with respect to x. And the first thing that we're going to need to do here is check for continuity. So let's look d dx. Now we're going to replace our u with our stream function plus d dy times negative. Now the derivative of the stream function with respect to x. This just equals d squared times stream of the stream function dx dy minus d squared dy dx, which is the same thing as dx dy, and that equals zero. We can finally do it for cylindrical coordinates, which is a little bit more complicated. So let's start by defining the stream function in cylindrical coordinates. So our V sub r equals 1 over r, the stream function with respect to theta, and our V theta equals minus the derivative of this stream function with respect to r. So again, we check for continuity. D dr of r vr times 1 over r plus 1 over r d v theta d theta, and we have to figure out if it equals 0. So we substitute our v sub r and our v sub theta into our equations with respect to our stream function. So we have 1 over r d dr, and there's our stream function, plus 1 over r d d theta, now minus the stream function, the derivative of the stream function with respect to r. Does that equal 0? So we have 1 over r, second derivative of the stream function, dr d theta, minus 1 over r times the second derivative of the stream function, d theta dr, and that equals 0.